Google continues to censor YouTubers and bloggers. We get these notes that our blogs and YouTubes are coming down because of spam, but they're blogs that are highly critical of Mayor Bloomberg and Christine Quinn. So we can't help but feel that people paid by them are marking all our work as spam, which is, it's insane. I mean, we knew that the media was suppressing voter anger, any news about that, anything to do with the opposition on behalf of these people. So number one, I need you to write press@google.com and demand Luis Flores' no third term blog be returned to him. He just posted last night that Christine Quinn was the head person in city council that signed off on the form that said you need to have a permit to protest if you have more than 50 people. That's Christine Quinn's dirty work. I'm sure Occupy Wall Street would be interested in that. And I think her thugs took down Luis Flores' blog. So to get it back, we need you to write press@google.com and tell them stop the censorship, better protective measures for political bloggers, because that's three bloggers. Me, Susanna B. Troy, my entire YouTube channel came down before the mayoral election. It took 28 hours, and Norman Siegel was my civil rights hero lawyer. He wrote their legal department, and all of you know who you are. You wrote on my behalf. Thank you. I love you. And Gary Tilzer, True News, his blog came down. Now, we all fought for him, Luis Flores and I, and at this point, it's 9:52, and Gary Tilzer hasn't done squat posting a blog post on behalf of Luis Flores. Thanks a lot, True News. And then we have my blog post. Just so you know, it's really important that you do look into Brookfield. I call him the landlord of Occupy Wall Street. Look into the fact they're worth $150 billion, and they have a lot of federal loans. You need to look at my blog posts on that. And also, the biggest news that no one's reporting except me, and I got it, put it all together from Gawker. I found a piece on Gawker. It has a picture of Rupert Murdoch and Michael Bloomberg and Rupert's extremely young wife, woman young enough to be his granddaughter. But she married Rupert Murdoch for clearly his sexy body and his personality only, nothing to do with his money and power. But basically the article was about the fact that John Liu was in charge of five New York pensions that had $95 million worth of stock in News Corp. And John Liu joined a group that demanded Rupert Murdoch be ousted as chair for the hacking scandals in England, which were awful. And so Rupert Murdoch and Michael Bloomberg put their heads together and they found a way to restructure the pensions. Now, the pensions needed to be restructured, but in the first term, and they restructured them in a way that John Liu has no power. Now, why is John Liu not fighting? Because mysteriously, the New York Times and the New York Daily News and the New York Post have been doing hatchet pieces on him. Surprise! Those were the same papers that pushed through Mike's third term and Christine Quinn. They cover up for them. They're very involved in all kinds of tech deals. And John Liu put the kibosh on a $27 million tech deal of Rupert Murdoch's for the Board of Ed Wireless Generation. So this was clearly orchestrated by Rupert Murdoch as well as Mike Bloomberg. And it's obscene because Mike has the biggest white collar crimes ever in New York City government, and that's City Time, ECTP, but also the pensions. They were raided, including by his best friend, Steve Rattner, who was banned by the SEC. And even after he was banned by the SEC, what does Mike do? Still keep him employed. So what does that tell you about Mike Bloomberg, who purged himself during the Hagerty trial, who needed immunity, all his workers for him needed immunity when they went in to be cross-examined in the Hagerty trial. And so my question, I called Stu Loser and asked, is Mike Bloomberg going to have Steve Rattner advise him on the pension restructuring, which, by the way, should have come in the first term, but they were too busy raiding the pensions to do any restructuring. And is Goldman Sachs going to be involved, considering that they mishandled the FDNY and NYPD pensions? And then Susan Edelman did a killer piece on that, and she also did one on the fact, I think it was about a decade of mishandling costs a fortune. It means we pay in certain ways. The taxpayers have to suck up some of this. It's a disaster for us as for the city. YouTube are so important, and you see how they've done everything to, the newspapers won't report anything about us. They didn't report the Occupy Wall Street healthcare protests. This is really scary stuff. So write press@google.com and demand Lewis's No Third Term blog returned to him.